Yo, what up? It's your boy Sean Kingston, and right now you're watching New Music Director, Your Artist, Your Music, and Your Link.
Hey, yo, Sean, you, Mr. Kingston.
I'm a young songwriter. Every record that I do, I put my Sean Kingston flavor on there. I'm from Jamaica, I'm from Miami, and I just always thought of me blending both of those together. I think I created a movement that's basically called Island Pop, basically mixing the Caribbean melodies with the pop fusion and R&B sounds. What makes my music feel good, for the most part, it's no cursing, no profanity. So all, you know, anybody can listen to it, all ages can listen to it. It's clean, it's catchy, when I mean feel good, I mean just, when you hear it, you just automatically want to get up and move or dance or sing along to it. You don't want to think about, your life, all your negative problems. You just want to party and have a great time. Feel good, so it's feel good music. I have my own lane, I stand out, and it's a blessing for me to work with all the people that I grew up to listening to and, wanting to work with. Life without nothing was, a lot of dreams. Thinking about, man, how I'm gonna get my big break, and wishing and hoping to now where I'm living my dream. I'm performing in front of thousands of people. It's a blessing. My background is, starts from my grandfather, Jack Ruby, a legendary sound man slash producer from Ocho Rios, Jamaica. His dad was from Kingston. He traveled from Kingston to Ochi, as a legitimate sound man, sound clashing all different sounds around the country. And he was the number one sound guy. The Wailers and Bob Marley used to always come play soccer with him and eat with him. He was very important to the reggae culture, in Jamaica. So that's where I really got my musical background from. I'm a mama's boy. My dad wasn't really always there for me as much as my mom was. She basically got incarcerated when I was like 14 years old. When she went away, I just remember everything just coming down, as far as life. Whatever she was doing, she always did it for her kids. She put her kids first. That's the type of mom she is. So I just wanted to make her proud. I just had to man up. Basically, everything that I thought was a joke, I had to come, it came to reality, man, I really gotta do this, and I gotta do it now. The only thing I wanted to do was music. When that happened, it was just like, okay, mom, when you get out, I'll have a record deal, I'll be on TV, and little do you know it, that's what happened. I remember me telling her all this stuff over the phone, and all that turned into reality. So, her getting arrested and incarcerated was a motivation to why I'm here now. Anything you want to do, you can do it. All this is happening off of music. So I can go to the next level and continue to make this happen, I gotta continue writing music. I always think about coming up with the next master plan, whether it's internet technology or, signing an artist or coming up with a shoe, whatever it is. It's just, I always try to think ahead of the next man. Just imagine you wanting something your whole life, and then you do a show at SOBs, and then from there performing at, Wembley, Madison, all these big places. It's crazy. It's just an inspiration. I think about those type of stuff. All the stuff I've been through, to me performing for sold out Madison Square Garden show, for me hooking up on songs with Justin Bieber and all these new people, it's just amazing. For the most part, I feel like it's God, because he knows that I really want to do it. He knows that I want it, and I have a passion for it. So, I guess he's just blessing me right now, so. What's up, y'all? I'm Sean Kingston, your new music director, your artist, your music, and your link.